Hello everyone, I'm the Soloist and welcome back to another episode of Fear 2 Project Origin. Alright. I read all of that info there last time. I'm really trying to finish up Fear 2. I'm trying to weed away from the PS3 just so it can take more of a break. Because even though I only use it for an hour a day, it's still using it every single day. You know, I want to make sure it's all right. It is an older system. You don't want to overwork something like that. I'm a little slow. It took me too long to think about the fact that it went into slow motion because I needed to run away from the falling bus so that I didn't die. That sure did injure me. That's not cool. Okay, she's getting closer to me. That's not good. Go ahead, stand up, bud. Whoa! Oh no. Okay. So. Gonna swap the laser for the pistol. Pick up whatever ammo I can get off of these guys. Make sure I reload the shotgun I was holding. Okay, I did. Oh, nice. That dude had health. Okay, so that's 100% the way to go. It's always kind of goofy after I complete, you know, my murdering business. It's just me getting to exist with just silence. You know, because there's nothing else. All the Alma moments are scripted. Oh. I didn't even recognize this as a door. Oh, whoa. Buddy back there has the laser pointer. Ow. Ow. That dude did like a whole barrels rolls worth of nonsense. Say, I was like, where's laser guy? Oh, come on now. Oh, the sadness of not using a mouse. It always comes up eventually to hurt you. Oh, all I've got left is this. Okay. Gotta pick up my scruples of war. Bullets. Oh, is that the hammerhead? Why have they given me that? Press the topple cover. More health, more mines. Oh, I could have closed this door. I could have stopped them from coming through. I could have stopped all the ghosts that were coming through. It's such a dumb joke. Okay. I noticed the train too late. Just a lot too late. My brain was like, oh, I've got to murder them. And then the train appeared. And I was just like, Okay. I was about to say, I was like, alright, what's with Murder Train here? Can I get inside the Murder Train? I don't think I should, I'm just curious. Go up some stairs. Laser manual. Troubleshooting guide for Shark FL3 laser weapon. Symptom: beam is dim and fails to cut through soft targets. Probable cause: low battery power. Solutions: recharge or replace batteries. Symptom: beam is split or scattered. Probable cause: emitter is dirty. Solutions: wipe the emitter with a soft, dry cloth. Note: be sure to power off the weapon before cleaning. Symptom: overheat light is flashing. Probable cause: cooling system failure. Solutions: shut off the device immediately. If the warning light doesn't switch off in 15 to 30 seconds, seek cover as the weapon may explode. Interesting. Ow, what the what? Oh. My automatic shotgun is full. It's just filled to the absolute brink with ammo. That guy probably could have gotten the drop on me if he didn't do what he did. I walked forward, and the screen went dark. That was a very goofy moment. A very goofy movie. Lieutenant Stokes sent you after Sergeant Keegan, who wandered off during a firefight and disappeared. He seems to believe he's pursuing a woman. Lieutenant Stokes has advised you to locate an armor cam cargo tunnel that should lead you to Still Island. She and Sergeant Morales will rendezvous with you there. And I still haven't found Keegan, right? Like, none of the flayed bodies were his. I like how it says it. Retrieve Sergeant Keegan. It was just there. I didn't. Did it just swap my pistol without me even pressing a button? I don't know how I feel about that. I also don't know how I feel about Beckett never talking, you know? Going through what he's going through, there should indeed be Beckett speech. You know? It's sort of that same thing, like the same Isaac Clarke syndrome is occurring. Where it's like, Isaac Clarke should talk, and he doesn't. And it doesn't make sense that he doesn't. And then he does in the second game. Someone back there. There's a missile launcher here? Gonna touch this water and have like a horrific flashback. Oh, never mind, I can go around it. Oh, whoa. What's with all the different weapons? Owie. Oh, snap. Well, it's what I've got. Cool. What was that guy hoping would happen? That I wouldn't, I don't know, be cool? That's a gun. Okay. What is happening over there? Keegan. She didn't even hold on to me that time. I think the bridge being out on the main road is the least of our worries currently. Oh. Okay. Slow down, man. Oh my God. Okay, that was a moment and a half. I guess that guy isn't still up there. Whoa. I enjoy that there's a lot of armor supplying, like, just in the background. Oh, wow. Okay. Who is hiding back there? But no one anymore. to know what these guys think they'd be able to do. Come on, let's repair up a little bit. You know, restabilize. Was a significantly easier fight than I thought it would be. Is that where I'm supposed to go? Okay, a lot of ghosts. Who's that at the end of the street? Keegan. What? You know, I'm starting to think Keegan might be a lost cause. Huh. I know some people might disagree with that, but it's starting to feel like Keegan might be a lost cause. Okay, must be going this way. See, I think this has been the most unique bit of design that we've done the entire game. This is 100% the most unique thing we've done so far. You've entered the Armor Cam cargo tunnel through a breach of what appears to be the epicenter of the explosion that devastated the city. Your goal is to reach the Still Island facility before Alma overwhelms you. You don't seem to be any closer to intercepting Sergeant Keegan. If anything, he seems to be moving further away. Yeah, I think Keegan is a lost cause, Mr. Beckett. Mr. Anderson. That's a bad joke. I was about to say, Beckett, why are you taking so long to get up? Kind of sense in my soul that the necessities of a sniper rifle are not going to be as useful down here in the underground. Well, I'm guessing that used to be the tunnel. That was the world's shortest ladder. Well, that's weird. The replica soldier is the ultimate warrior, incredibly fast, incomparably strong, impeccably trained, and utterly devoid of conscience. No history, no hang-ups, and no purpose but to serve. Unquestioning loyalty and unshakable discipline at standard PMC prices. Variant 7 replica soldiers accept voice-keyed verbal orders. Standard soldiers recognize 12 unique voices, but 24 or 32 voice extended capacity is available, and are pre-configured to obey telepathic orders once the Harbinger Telesthetic Commander series becomes available. Release date pending. Is that guy's face out? Looks like these guys aren't wearing their mask. Huh. I was like, yeah, I kind of shot you in the face. I was trying to see what their faces looked like. I was curious. Transport System Manual Operation Guidelines. The recommended procedure to operate the Armored Camp Subterranean Transport System manually is not to operate the system manual. I'm sorry, what? The recommended procedure to operate the Armored Camp Subterranean Transport System manually is not to operate the system manually. Tram cars have been pre-programmed with detailed route information to ensure that they automatically change configuration to conform to the layout of each tunnel section. If cars are not properly aligned, a collision is probable, resulting in needless cost incurrence as well, as hideous personal injury or loss of life. Anyone determined to be at fault for a manual operation accident may face salary reduction, wage garnishment, termination, or cancellation of life insurance benefits in the event that the individual did not survive. That is so highly funny, but I can't place in my soul why that was so funny to read to me. It just was. There's a sound occurring in here that I don't know if I like. Alright, it wants me to exercise caution. Who's gonna fly down and make me have to murder them? Who said that? Excuse? Oh, what? I didn't know they were coming from both directions, or else I wouldn't have stood so still. Okay, so this is the furthest forward. Got it. I realized I wasn't talking that whole time, which is probably significantly more eerie than it had any right to be, and I apologize for that. Okay, no, it's one of those items I can't interact with. Got it. I know someone is trying to shoot at me, I just don't know where they are. Okay. Obstruction detected. There's no one on this half. Oh, I saw you back there for a split second. I don't know where he got to, though. There is a replicant soldier left. Yeah, see, there they are. Finally. Ow, what? There's still some of you up there? God. Oh, yeah. No, that was expected. I spent all my time trying to get rid of the one dude that was left, and then they were like, here's 20 more. Teehee. Excuse me, where did you come from? Yep. Gotta get through this section. Gotta find the best spot to not get. Why is this section so unexpectedly hard? They're able to significantly more easily overwhelm me, and it does not help that I have to aim with what I have to aim with. Also, let me start with this. Whoa, stay down. Oh, I was doing so well about it too. I was doing so well about it. Mamma mia, pasteria. This can't be the spot where I get stuck. That would be horribly disheartening. I'm supposed to get stuck now in an infinite jump scare loop or something. Not in this nonsense. No, you were supposed to die. Jesus. Why is there so many? There's so many of them. It's ridiculous. Let's try going this way again. The ones without masks on don't even say words. They just make noises. Come rumba. Alright, no. Whatever. I'm gonna leave it there. Thank you guys so much for joining for this episode of Fear 2. If you liked it, make sure to leave a like and comment down below. Some of the games you're going to see on the channel. And if you feel so inclined, check out everything else that I do at the link down in the description. I've been the Soloist. Thank you guys so much for watching. Check out whatever YouTube's tossing up over there. And I'll see all of you tomorrow.